Oh, it's A and M. That is M.
That is A and M.
That am A and M.
That am A and M video.
If you're into fun and you love to play,
if you like funny jokes, then put you away.
If you like to dance to a slamming sound and you like having lots of friends around,
and if you're one of those kids who lives by the rule that sad is bad and happy is cool,
ooh, little buddy, you're about to see you're in the very best place that you could be.
Hey, it's Lamb Chops, play along.
Where kids come to play along, and fun things are all we ever do.
Yeah, it's Lamb Chops, play along.
Come join the kids and play along.
We got a lot of good stuff for you.
Make a muscle, squeeze it tight. Really squeeze with all your might. Now the other arm. Let me see just how strong you've grown to be. Make two muscles, left and right. Come on and pump it up. Out of sight. Hey, you're getting strong.
Now let's go back to the song.
Lamb Chops, play along.
Where kids come to play along, and fun things are all we ever do.
Yeah, it's Lamb Chops, play along.
Join the kids and play along.
We got a lot of good stuff for you.
And you.
And you.
And you.
And you.
Yeah, and especially you. It's betcha time, it's betcha time. And though I've never met ya, I know something you can't do. I betcha, 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 I'll teach ya how to do what I propose. Ready, set, here goes.
I betcha, I betcha, I betcha I can show you something that nobody, nobody, nobody has ever seen before. And you're going to see it, and then nobody, nobody will ever see it again. Guess what it is? You give up? It's a peanut. Oh, yeah. Nobody has ever seen this before. And now you've seen it. And now nobody's ever going to see it again. What a nutty betcha! When I was in Mexico, I heard a funny joke. I heard it in Spanish. And I only speak a little Spanish, but I love to speak Spanish. And so I wrote down the joke in Spanish, and I translated it so I can do it for you. All right, now, and you can do it for your friends and for your parents. It's pretty funny. You hold up your hand, while you hold up your hand like this, and you say, "Here's the baby. Mama says don't touch the baby. Papa says don't touch the baby. Grandma says don't touch the baby. Grandpa says don't touch the baby. Sister says don't touch the baby. Now, Wiley, do you remember where's the baby? Don't touch the baby."
Oh, I betcha that I could spell my name backwards in the same amount of time it takes to spell it forwards. And you know, that's hard. Here I go. My name is Lamb Chop. L A M B C H O T. That's forwards. And now, backwards. L A M B C H O T. You get it? Oh, good. Try it on a friend. Only use your name, not mine.
My father taught me how to do this trick when I was just about your age. And how old are you? Yeah, isn't that a coincidence? That's how old I was. Yeah, and when you do this trick, you are going to amaze your mother and your father. You need a quarter. You can borrow a quarter. You don't have to have your own. And a pack of cards. You put the quarter down on the table. You cover the quarter with the pack of cards, and you say, "Presto Change-o," and... Look! The quarter has turned into a penny! Is that an amazing trick? Yay! Well, it's not so amazing if you know how the trick was done. Okay, how did I turn a quarter into a penny? There's the quarter. It got stuck to the back of the pack of cards because what I did was I put double-faced tape, sticky tape, on the back of the pack. So the quarter stuck. And when I started, I started with the penny hidden behind the quarter. You see, a penny is not only less than a quarter, a penny is smaller than a quarter. So I put the penny and the quarter down on the table, and nobody could see the penny because it was under the quarter. I covered it with the sticky part of the pack, and I went, presto change-o! And the quarter turned into the penny. Did you get it that time? It's the easiest way I know to turn a quarter into a penny, and it's a wonderful trick, unless your parents do it with your allowance, in which case it's a crummy trick. Ooh.
Hush, puppy. It's a betcha. I betcha that you can mention any animal, and I'll draw one.
Oh, I didn't know you could draw so good.
Yep, yep. You mention any animal, and I'll draw one.
All right. A rhinoceros,
Good, Cirrus. All right. Look the other way.
What are you doing?
Doing what I said I was going to do.
What?
Well, I said mention any animal, and I would draw one.
Yeah.
You said rhinoceros.
Yeah.
So I drew one.
I can't believe she's sucking me into that one.
Try it on a friend. I'll bet you you'll like it. This is my book on rope tricks, and I learned a rope trick in it that I'm going to teach to you. And since it's a rope trick, I'm going to do it with a rope. Now, this is a rope. And you can do this trick with a rope or with a ribbon or with a piece of string. You lay it down and you say to your friends, I bet you that I can grab hold of the ends of this rope and tie a knot without letting go of the ends. And then your friends will grab it, and they'll try all of this and all of that. Oh, I've seen them do it. Not your friends, but mine. And then you say, here's how you can grab the ends of a rope and tie a knot without letting go of the ends. Have you figured it out? No? Here's how you do it. You fold your arms, and in one hand, you grab one end, and in the other hand, you grab the other end. And then you unfold your arms, and you've made a knot without letting go of the ends. The reason you're able to do it is because you actually fold the knot in your arms. Then when you grab it, you transfer the knot from your arms to the rope. That's a good trick, is it not?
It's a magic trick. And you say to your friends, please tell me the names of your favorite TV shows. Skylar, you first. I'm going to write them down. Go ahead.
Tiny Toon Adventures.
I'm going to shorten it. Okay. And I'm folding that up, and I'm putting it into the bag. There we go. And you name one?
Road to Avonlea.
The Road to Avonlea. Okay. And I crumple it up, and I put it into the bag. Now you name another one.
Bugs Bunny.
Bugs Bunny, okay. And I crumple it up, and I put it into, but name another one.
Growing Pains.
Okay, and you name another one. Go ahead.
Ninja Turtles.
Okay. Now, I have written a great many names on a great many little pieces of paper, right? Okay. Would you reach into the bag and pick out any one? Do not look at it. Just take it. Yes, yes. Okay, take it and hold it in your hand. And now I'm going to crumple up the rest of the papers. And I'm going to concentrate very hard. Oh, I'm concentrating. And I think reading your mind, the one in your hand is Tiny Toon Adventures. Look at it. And what is it? Is it?
Tiny Toon Adventures.
Show them that I did it! Hooray for me! And now would you like to know how you do this trick? Would you like to know how? The secret is rather goofy. The first thing he said was Tiny Toon Adventures. So I wrote Tiny Toon Adventures on the paper. No matter what anybody else said, I wrote Tiny Toon Adventures. I wrote
Tiny Toon Adventures. I wrote Tiny... I wrote Tiny Toon Adventures on every... Nobody knew that. You didn't know that, did you? No. So no matter what I picked out of the bag, what did I pick out?
Tiny Toon
Adventures. This is a trick where you cannot make a mistake. And that's the kind of trick I like, where you cannot make a mistake. Thank you very much. Oh, we're having a picnic. You want to join us?
I do. I'm starved.
Oh. You want some punch?
You can't eat punch. I'm starving. I want something I can sink my teeth into, like a 12-pound marshmallow.
How about a sliced banana?
I'd settle for sliced ice.
Oh, well, I happen to have a banana. Oh, I'll share it with you.
Yeah, wait a second. That's mine.
Why won't you share it with them?
Well, there's a lot of people out there.
Yeah, but this is pre-sliced, you see, so it'll be very easy to divide up.
What do you mean, a pre-sliced banana?
Watch. As I said, this really is a pre-sliced banana. See, I'll peel it, and you will see that it is totally pre-sliced. There are all the separate slices of the banana.
Well, that's great! But, you know, in a million years, you'd never find another banana like that one, all sliced inside its skin.
I didn't find that banana, Charlie Horse. I sliced that banana.
You sliced the banana?
Yes.
While it still had its peel on?
Yes.
Well, how'd you do that? I mean, how'd you get in there? Did the banana have a back door that I didn't know about?
Huh? I sliced the banana before we started. And you can do it, too. It will make everybody go. Here's how you do it. You start with a banana, which is logical, and a needle. And you stick the needle... I started. You stick the needle into the banana, but you don't go through all the way so that you break the skin on the other side. You just cut through the soft part of the banana, and then you bring the needle all the way around, slicing it all the way around, cutting through the soft part, and then you take the needle out. Nobody will see that hole because you hold that away from them. And then you put the needle in a little lower, and you go all around breaking the meat of the banana, but not the skin. You put it in again and again and again, and you will find that when you peel the banana... Let me peel this one for you. Goodness. Okay, when you peel the banana, see, I just made a couple of slices, your banana will be totally pre-sliced. So you can just take your banana and split. You know, when you do a groaner, I mean, something that's so silly, people will go, oh, and then they'll turn around and do it to the next person they meet. Always. This is a groaner. You say, I betcha that I can stick out my tongue and touch my ear. And then everybody will make funny faces and go, and try to touch their tongue with their... touch their ear with their tongue. And when they're all finished making those funny faces, you do what you said you were going to. You stick out your tongue.
And you touch your ear. That's all.
Lamb Chop and I are going to show you a betcha. You say to your friend, I betcha that I can spread this piece of newspaper and put it in a place where you and I can both stand on it and we won't be able to touch each other. Can you figure that out? No, how about you? Your friends will say, no, where can you put that paper where we can both stand on it and we won't be able to touch each other? And then you show them. You open a door and you put the paper across the sill. And then you close the door. Lamb Chop, you stand on that side. And I'm going to stand on my side and close this door. And we won't be able to touch each other because the door will be in between. Try it. Now, this is a stunt that will probably work on somebody who's younger than you are.
I'm younger than you are.
It will probably work. Actually, it's a story.
I love stories.
Okay, you'll love this. It's a story about two brothers. Pete and Repeat went down to the river in a boat. Pete fell out. Who was left?
Repeat.
I'd be delighted to. Pete and Repeat went down to the river in a boat. Pete fell out. Who was left?
Repeat.
Of course. Pete and Repeat went down to the river in a boat. Pete fell out. Who was left?
Repeat!
Pete and Repeat went down to the river in a boat. Who was left?
Repeat!
I'd be delighted to. Pete and Repeat went down to the river in a boat. Who was left?
I can't take it anymore.
You know, most magicians need a magic wand for doing their tricks. But I don't imagine you have a magic wand at home, and I certainly don't have one in the backyard. But I've got a magic pen. And I'm going to show you how to do a wonderful trick. But first, I'll do it for you. Now, I'm going to show my hand empty, completely empty. And now I'm going to put my pen into my fist, and I'm going to tap the pen through my fist. And with my magic pen, I tap my hand on both sides. And when I open my hand, a dime has appeared inside my fist. Would you like to know how to do that? Bet you would, bet you would. Here's what I did. Before I started, you know, most pens have prongs. The prongs are for putting the pen onto a pocket like that. Well, instead of putting it on your pocket, you take it and you wedge a dime under the prong. And then you just hold it between your two fingers. You didn't see that there before I started. Uh-uh. And then I showed my hand empty on one side, empty on the other. I put the pen into my fist, pushed it through, tapped my fist with the magic pen, and the dime appeared once again. This is a trick that really makes sense. 10 cents. With these two strings, one string, two strings, I am going to show you a magic trick. Amanda, you hold this string. Sabrina, you hold this string. Hold your hands up. Hold on, don't let go. Hold them up high. Okay, I'm gonna hold both ends in my hand. And Sabrina, when I say three, you pull on your end. And Amanda, you pull on your end, okay? Here we go. Ready? One, two, three, pull! And the two strings have joined into one string. Ta-da! It's magic. Well, it's magic unless you know how. And then it's just plain fun. You want to learn how? All right, come close, girls, and I'll show you. Many strings can be separated if you just pull the strands apart. And then you hold it and you twist the strands into kind of horns. See, now there's the string with horns. And if you pinch right at the point of those horns, it looks like you've got one string, two strings, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Now, you hold one end and you hold the other end, and I'm grabbing this part in the center. But when I said, Sabrina, pull, Amanda, pull, I had already done the trick and pulled it. And so then I said, one, two, three, pull. And the string is joined like that. And if you watch us every day, you'll be able to string along with us. You want to try it? Sure, go ahead. I'm going to tell you a magical story, very magical, and you can do it. The story and the magic trick. It's about two thieves and seven chickens. Now, I don't happen to have any chickens. If you've got chickens, you can use chickens. But otherwise, like me, you can use seven anything. Anything at all. Seven pennies. I'm using seven little balls of paper. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Once upon a time, a farmer had seven chickens. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And there were two thieves who decided to steal the seven chickens and share them equally. So one thief stole a chicken, then the second thief stole a chicken, then the first one took a chicken, then the second one took a chicken, then the first one took a chicken, then the second one took a chicken, and whoops! What happened then was the farmer came back. So very quickly, one put back a chicken, the other put back a chicken, the other put back a chicken, and then the farmer went away. Well, the first one took a chicken, the second one, oops, the farmer came back. So one put back a chicken, the other put back a chicken, the other put back a chicken, and then the farmer caught them. Gotcha with the goods, said the farmer. Now you would have thought that since the two thieves had shared the chickens equally, they would be caught with equal goods. But no, the first one had two chickens, while the second had none. He was empty-handed, and so the farmer had to let him go. Now, would you like to know how that trick is done? The secret is that when you pick up the thingy, the chicken, when you pick it up, you always pick up with your right hand first, then your left,
then your right, then your left. But when you put them down on the table, you always put them down with your left hand first, and then your right, and then your left. And so there's always more in the right hand than there is in the left. And if you do that trick, all about thieves and chickens, you will absolutely steal the show.
I got a betcha, I got a betcha.
Okay, what is it?
My betcha is this. I betcha that you cannot, not tear this piece of paper into four equal parts.
Of course I can tear a piece of paper into four equal parts.
I bet you can, and if you can, I'll give you a quarter.
Where are you going to get a quarter?
Don't worry, I just want to see you tear this paper into four equal parts.
It's very simple to tear a piece of paper into four equal parts. You fold it in half, and then you just rip along your fold. There we go. And then you take the two pieces and you fold it in half again. There we go. And you sharpen the fold with your fingernail, open it up, and once again, just tear along your fold, and there we go, Lamb Chop. We have four equal pieces of paper. You see, I was able to tear the sheet into four equal parts. What's the matter with you? Where's my quarter?
There's your quarter.
That's a quarter of the sheet of paper. I get it.
But I bet you didn't.
I'm gonna teach you a magic trick, and it's such a good trick, your parents will go, ooh! They won't understand how it's done. I promise you do it with your bare hands and with a deck of cards. You probably have a deck of cards around the house. You take it out of the pack and you shuffle the cards because it's very difficult to shuffle cards when they're in the pack. And then you need a friend. Brian, come be my friend. This is my friend Brian. Brian, pick a card, any card. I truly don't care what card you pick.
Oh, no, not that one.
I'm teasing. Okay, now, you remember it? Show it to everybody.
Okay.
Don't let me see it. Okay, and put it down on top of the deck and don't let me see it. Okay. All right, now I'm going to put the cards back into the pack, which is the hardest part of this. There we go. And now, Brian, I want you to think hard of your card and say, my card, rise.
My card, rise.
And Brian's card. Brian, is that your card?
Yeah.
Was that Brian's card? Well, there you go. Isn't that a wonderful trick? Would you like to know how to do this wonderful trick? Shake your head so I can hear the rattle. You would. Good. Here's how you do it. You take the deck of cards, and you shuffle them, and then somebody picks a card. Pick a card, any card. I don't care which one it is. Remember it. Show it to everybody.
Okay.
Okay. Now put it on top of the deck and don't let me see it. Now here's where the trick comes. Brian, put it on top. But when I put it into the package, I put it in back. And the reason that I did that was, at home, before I came here, when I was alone, I cut a hole in the back of the package. Why did I do that? So that when I wanted Brian's card to rise, all I had to do is push with my thumb, and the back card rose, and that card was Brian's card. I'm going to teach you a trick that my papa taught me when I was, a little girl, and it's a really good trick. You start with a penny and a quarter. You put the penny on top of the quarter, and you say, now, I'm going to remove the penny and put it in my pocket, and you close your hand real tight. And then you say to your friends, where's the penny? And they say, it's in your pocket. And you say, no, it's back in my hand. And they'll be shocked, because they won't know how it's done. Only I'm going to tell you. Here's how it's done. Into your hand, you put a penny. On top of it, you put a quarter. The secret to the trick is that you've got two pennies, so you put the other penny on top. You understand you have a penny underneath, a quarter in the middle of the sandwich, and a penny on top. It's a penny sandwich. Then when you take this penny away, you close your hand, and what are you really doing? You're turning the coins upside down, so the bottom penny is now on top of the quarter. So when you say to your friends, where's the penny? They'll say, it's in your pocket. You say, no, it's back in my hand. They'll say, how did you do that? And it doesn't make any sense to tell them. Just say, it's magic.
Shari.
Oh! Yes, Brian.
I got a betcha.
Oh, well, I'll put aside my book for a betcha anytime. Anyway, I lost my place. What's the betcha?
I betcha can't carry water in a sieve.
You betcha that I can't carry water in a sieve? Sieve has holes in it. Wait a minute. I don't think I can carry water in a sieve. No. I'll bet you can't carry water in a sieve.
I bet you I can.
All right. Show me. How do you carry water in a sieve? That's not water. Those are ice cubes.
No, ice cubes are frozen water.
Ice cubes are frozen water. You're right! So you say to your friends, I bet you I can count higher on my fingers than you can. And then your friends will count on their fingers. Go ahead, count on your fingers.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Good. Now I'm going to count higher on my fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Did I count higher?
No.
Oh.
I thought I did.
Here's a betcha you can do with any coin from any country. You can do it with 3 pennies, or 3 nickels, or 3 quarters. I'm using 3 quarters, because they're big, and so you can really see what I'm doing. The betcha is, I betcha I can take this N quarter and move it away without touching it. And then your friends will try blowing it away, you know. Of course, they won't be able to do it. And you show how you can move the end quarter away without touching it. You take your pointer finger and you put it on the middle. And then you take your other pointer finger on the other end and you bang it. You just knock it. And the vibrations will go through the middle coin and knock the other coin out of the way. It's a very good betcha. Don't knock it. This is my friend Sabrina. She's 6. I'm older. Yes, that's right. Nevertheless, she and I are going to show you a betcha. A betcha can't do it, you'll say to somebody. And it will astonish you. You can do it with your mother or your father or your biggest brother or sister. Sabrina, put your finger on your head. You will put your finger on your head, and then you will say, grab my wrist, and they'll grab your wrist, and you'll say, try without jerking to pull my finger off my head. And they'll go, I was trying as hard as I could. I'm going to try again. I cannot lift her finger off her head. Nobody will be able to lift your finger off unless they jerk it, which is not fair. Brian, come here. Just in case they think that I'm faking. Here is Sabrina's finger on her head. Mm-hmm. You grab her wrist, and without jerking, just a good steady pull, try to pull her hand off her head.
Okay.
Oh, you'll get a lot of laughter, I've no doubt. I betcha if you'll only try it out. I betcha.
This is the song that doesn't end. Yes, it goes on and on, my friend. Some people started singing it, not knowing what it was. And they'll continue singing it forever just because this is the song that doesn't end.
Oh, no.
Yes, it goes on and on, my friend.
That's enough, guys.
Some people started singing it, not knowing what it was. And they'll continue singing it forever just because this is the song that doesn't end.
How do I turn you off?
Yes, it goes on and on, my friend.
Okay. I can't believe you guys. If you guys are going to keep that up, I want you to go far, far away. Go, go, go. No, no, no. Keep on going. Woo, woo.
This is the song that...
Charlie, horse! No, no, stop, stop, stop. Charlie, stop. I want you to go away. Go away. And don't slam the...
door.
Hey, what's that? Oh, I know, it's a P. Wait a sec, I could do it. Parachute.
Paragon.
They're all gone.
Well, that's true.
All gone.